Cologne is my haven. Like, I'm traveling a lot and I'm always happy to come back to the city. The city of Cologne has adopted me about 25 years ago. It's a place where you can actually have tranquility and be just a private person. If you want action, you can go out. There's plenty of opportunities for that. But what I really appreciate about Cologne is the quality of life in general. It's a very green city. It's bicycle friendly, which is an important thing to me, as I don't have a car. It's just a city that suits me. I don't know if that's directly reflected in my music. I think something like Kompakt would have happened in a different city as long as I would have met the same people. It's more a social thing than a local thing. I'm a natural-born DJ. That's something that I've done for the largest part of my life. I started DJing when I was 14 years old, so that's like 30 plus years on the job. It's my greatest passion. Producing is something that I started much later, in 1994, I think, just out of curiosity to see what happens if I lock myself up in a studio and if I'm able at all to produce something. When I was a child, I was pretty sure that I would become a composer. That's something that always fascinated me. I thought I would write an opera or something like that. Well, it didn't come to that, but creating music or being creative is something that has been always important to me from early childhood on. And due to the fact that I'm traveling so much and that I also have responsibilities here in the company, producing was always more like a hobby for me. Only in the recent, let's say, 5 years, I felt urge to spend more time in the studio and get better with it. And like now I would call myself a producer, but for the largest part of my career, I was merely a hobby fiddler. As I don't have much time to produce, I'm always so happy to be in the studio when I finally get the occasion. I usually work at nighttime. I consecrate one night a week for studio, Tuesday nights when I've recovered from the weekend. But when I finally get to the studio, I'm usually so eager to work and inspired that when I leave the studio, there's a result. I never had a writer's block. This is something I don't know. I'm definitely not a sound scientist or I'm not a geeky guy in general. I'm happy when things are just working, you know. If I have to go through update hell, that's like the worst thing that can happen to me. I hate that technical stuff. But I know how to handle the things I've got. And for me, it's more like getting the maximum out of a relatively small setup than just collecting machines and wire things up. I think I got traumatized as a child. My father, he has a model train, you know, like a full room of that. And I was never allowed to play with it when I was young because I would always, like, you know, break things. And so nowadays for me, like when I have to pluck all the instruments, to me it feels a lot like these model trains, and it's just something I don't like. I grew up in the 80s, and pop music has always played an important role in my life. My general approach to electronic music, be it as an A&R for the label or as a DJ, is always very heavily influenced by pop music. I'm not using records as tools too much. I would rather play them from beginning to the end. And I like this narrative element in music. I like to tell a story with my DJ set, and I like to tell a little story within a track. I just can't keep a loop going for 5 minutes. That's something that's not in me. It's nothing bad, you know, it's something I like, something I would eventually like to play, but I can't do it. I need to tell a little story and have a proper arrangement. Overall, I wouldn't consider myself as a nostalgic person. So when the next wave of a revival, let's say the 90s deep house revival that was happening in the last years, it's something that just doesn't touch me. Even if I lived this music when it happened, but I don't see the point in pulling out like 50 old records from 1994 and play those in 2016. That feels wrong. I'm always curious for the new and the now and the tomorrow, but when there's an Italo disco revival, I'm like, yeah, it's nice for the next generation to discover this now, but there was a moment for that music, and for me that moment has passed. I'm not very much of an archaeologist. I prefer to look forward to something new.